time
for Nerdgasm.
Hey, what's up, guys? Jerry here, aka Barnacles, and today we're going to be talking about some of the problems and privacy issues with the Windows 10 Creators Update. Now, the update just went live today on 4/11/2017. You can actually go into Windows Update and force the install yourself, or you can just wait a couple of months and Microsoft will sneak it onto your box without your permission in the middle of the night. Now, one of the first major issues with the update is that it resets all of your default applications, regardless of how you install it. When the install is complete, you're going to find the Edge is now your default browser again. You're going to find that Cortana is back on your box if you disabled it using one of the mini programs out there. Basically, they take it back to default. Now, Microsoft in the past has claimed that they're not doing this on purpose, that it's a bug or an artifact, but Microsoft specifically tests for this. And I know because I used to be an employee there, and I know that we always test to make sure the default settings weren't touched. The reason that they're doing this is they're hoping that by forcing people continuously to go back and try Edge and try Cortana and try all these things, they're basically going to convince you or beat you into submission into just accepting it and using it. And I'm not saying that Edge is a terrible browser. Actually, Edge is probably one of the better browsers that Microsoft has made, especially when you compare it to Internet Explorer. But forcing people to use these applications isn't the right way to go about it. And this all wraps up into that new business model that Microsoft's following that's just strong arm the customer. Trust me, they won't care.
Guess what, Satya? They do care.
I'm one of them. But the elephant in the room, as always, is the privacy issues. And of course, Creators Update has done some things to alleviate some of the stress of the public. And one of those things is now they publish all of the information that they're collecting at two levels, the basic level and the full level. Well, when you install the update by default, it's going to go ahead and select the full level for you, which is basically going to tell them every website you're visiting, what apps you're opening, what the file names are that you're opening, along with a laundry list of other information that they have published. And I'll have the links to their actual articles telling you what data is collected. But the thing that surprised me the most was that the basic data collection level is 90% of the data. The full set just adds on some actual data that most people wouldn't want collected no matter what. And keep in mind, that is the default setting. So let's say that you go ahead and back it off to the basic setting. They're still collecting a plethora of information from your computer. And one of the things that really bothered me and drove me absolute nuts is that if you scroll down the list, you'll see one that says that they collect your IMEI number from your mobile device. Basically, if you have a SIM card in your tablet or in your laptop or even in your phone running the Windows 10 operating system, what they're getting from you is the IMEI. Now, that's your personally identifiable number on your cellular network. With that number, your cell provider knows exactly who you are and everything that is transacted between your mobile device and their cellular towers. Now, Microsoft goes out of their way to state that this is not a violation of privacy because they don't have access to those databases with the IMEI number, so they don't have your personal data. But the thing, this is the thing that bugs me about Microsoft, is that right now they're telling everybody, oh, no, we're not collecting that. That's not personally identifiable. But the truth is it absolutely is personally identifiable because anybody can call up a cell provider and pretend to be you, issue the IMEI number, and get back information from the cell provider. Also, another scenario is, and this could happen, Microsoft could partner with the company, because keep in mind, Microsoft partners with a lot of companies. They could partner with AT&T or Verizon or T-Mobile or Sprint, and by partnering with those companies, they would gain access to those databases, and then they could link that data together. And now every piece of data they connected from your computer linked to that IMEI number can now be linked to the other database, which is your mobile data transactions and things like that. But Microsoft can actually take this another step, and they don't say in the information collected that they have your login information, which is your Windows Live account, which Microsoft pretty much strong arms you to create now in Windows 10. There is a way to create a local account, but they make it nightmarishly hard to do and not intuitive at all. But you end up creating a Live account. Well, that Live account contains your email address, and if you were dumb, all of your real information, including your address, phone number, all that stuff that you decided to input when you created the Live account. Now, Microsoft has that. And whenever they're uploading data from your computer via telemetry, that is linked to that account, which means that every single piece of data that they're collecting from your computer that they claim is not personally identifiable is linked back to that account, which is personally identifiable. So you guys following me here? Microsoft absolutely has a database that can track and connect any piece of data that originates from your computer back to you. unless you were smart enough just to put in all BS information and your name is like IP Freely and your address is 1234 Bakalaka Daka Drive, then you're probably safe. And guys, just so you know, this isn't tinfoil hat. This isn't me. All this information you can go out and validate yourself. Microsoft now discloses all of the information that they collect. So you can go through that laundry list and you'll probably find other little tidbits of information that can be personally identifiable or information you don't want collected, like which apps you're opening all the time. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys don't want Microsoft to know that you're opening up uTorrent EXE 50 times a day and that your IMEI number is linked to several terabytes of data downloaded from sources you probably shouldn't be doing. And also, most of us, not all of us, probably don't want Microsoft knowing that we're going to Pornhub 10,000 times a day.
Not that I do that.
But my point here is Microsoft is giving the illusion that they're giving us what we want finally by showing us all of the information that they're collecting at these two levels. But I'm gonna push back and say, one, Microsoft says that this is the data collected as of the creator's update. That does not mean that they weren't collecting more data before. They haven't even made a statement to this fact. They're basically saying, as of the creator update, we're gonna tell you this is what we're collecting. Well, there's still a lot of evidence showing that Microsoft was logging keystrokes from the machine because in past videos, and some other people pushing a keystroke on the keyboard, the network monitor showed a bit of traffic going up to Microsoft in an encrypted packet. Why is it every keystroke was sending some kind of data to Microsoft when you were typing in the search boxes inside of Explorer? Well, the answer is because they were keylogging. Now, however they want to justify it or however they want to say that that data isn't personally identifiable, I don't believe it for a second because I, for one, played around with Microsoft's databases for years internally with the Ware system, the Watson system, all the Windows error reporting, all of that. And all of that data was easily interlinked and relational. Those databases were highly relational, meaning it was very easy to take one database and link it to another database and link it to another database and get a much clearer picture. So I'm not buying the story. And the other thing is Microsoft showing you what they collect now. Again, that's not probably what they collected before. So I am going to be inclined to say that privacy probably isn't as bad in the creator's update as it has been in the past, because I'm sure Microsoft pulled out a lot of things that were like, oh crap, we shouldn't be collecting that. But that doesn't mean that they're still not collecting a ton more data than you would want. And the other thing that makes me upset about this is they do have the basic level and they have the full level. And the basic level, like I said, had 90% of all of the data collected. I would expect the basic level to be the more bare option. You select basic, it collects like five or six things from your computer instead of 10,000. And this list is huge. If you scroll down this list, you're going to see just how many things are on it. And it's pretty freaking massive and scary how much information they're transacting from your computer to the cloud. Now, there are a lot of people that are going to say telemetry makes software better and it allows Microsoft to see the software running in the ecosystem and respond to it and make better software. And I'm not arguing that's a lie. They're absolutely right. What I'm arguing is that it should be our decision on whether or not we want to participate in that system with software that we paid for. Now, I would like to petition Microsoft, and I hope that you guys petition Microsoft also, to include an option to disable telemetry, completely disable it. You select that option, you do not transact any information to the Microsoft servers, and they just piss off. And I don't care if this option has a huge warning that pops up. This is, by doing this, you're probably screwing your fellow Microsoft user out of, you know, having a better experience in the long run. But let's be honest, guys, since telemetry has founded, quality has actually gone down. So Microsoft is not using this data in a very meaningful way, because Windows 10 quality hasn't improved that greatly over time. And compared to the past operating systems like Windows 7 and where it was at, and also the conspiracy where Microsoft's trying to get everybody to upload or update from Windows 7 to Windows 10 because they're claiming modern processors will no longer be supported on Windows 7, which is completely bullshit. And I have an entire video on that also linked in the video description. But Microsoft's tactics have just gotten a little bit out of control here, guys. I disagree with just about everything that they're doing, and I would love to hear what you guys think about it down in the comments down below. And I would like to end this video by saying that I actually think Windows 10 is a good operating system. I think the improvements to the kernel and the HAL are very respectable. The resource consumption is the lowest, all-time low of any Microsoft product ever created. The Edge browser isn't that great, but it has made strides, and it is infinitely better than Internet Explorer. And especially if you're on a touch-enabled surface, it's actually a pretty nice browser. So I'm going to go ahead and give them that. Where I am complaining right now is how Microsoft is putting such an emphasis on collecting information from you and I in their database while keeping on a smile and telling the public that don't worry, none of this data is personally identifiable, when that is the biggest BS story anybody has ever told in every piece of data that's sent to Microsoft is absolutely personally identifiable. And if you guys end up getting wrapped up in some kind of court case or something like that, whether it be a nasty divorce, whether it be something where law enforcement is concerned with something you're downloading or somebody's investigating a network in an area and they subpoena that information from Microsoft, they can link it to several other databases of mobile carriers. And who knows how many other databases have that linking information? Because remember, to tie two databases together, you only need one piece of information. It's referred to as a key. And if you have that key piece of information to align those two pieces of info, everything else cascades and aligns along with it, and it starts to draw a bigger picture. Also, I would like to thank the entire community, and hopefully that means you who's watching this video, for leaning on Microsoft and forcing them to do the right things. A lot of the complaints that we did in the beginning led to the Creators Update disclosing all of the information that Microsoft is collecting, and that's something that in the past they have kicked and kicked and kicked and would not disclose. And a lot of our loud voices led to the European Union, or what's left of it, fighting against Microsoft, saying that they will not tolerate or even calling the action illegal, the collection of data without their knowledge. And Microsoft definitely felt the pressure, and Microsoft responded. But guys, still stay vigilant. Make sure that if you're running one of the programs right now to disable all the privacy features, like destroy Windows 10 spying, disable Win tracking, do not spy 10, Windows 10 privacy, and shit, I love the name of that one, Windows 10 privacy fixer, W10 privacy, etc. If you're running one of those programs, please realize that if you run it after the creator's update, it may not be working in its entirety. These programs usually modify registry keys, and I've heard from several people now that Microsoft is ignoring a lot of the privacy registry keys and allowing it to just continue down, and they change the entire privacy model. So chances are that a lot of those settings, even though they say they're working, they're probably not. So make sure that you're using a network monitor of some kind or checking your router logs and seeing how many connections your computer's making to Microsoft after you apply those settings to see if there is something fishy there. And I'm going to be doing my own research on this moving forward. Remember, the Creators Update just came out today. So I'll probably be doing a follow-up video here in the next couple of weeks after using the Creators Update to let you guys know what I think about it, what problems I've encountered, what pros and cons, because I'm sure there's going to be some cool stuff in there too. I've been reading about some of the features that they've added in there, especially around the Windows update system, that I'm very excited about, because it'll lessen the pressure on us to just have random updates dropped on our head in the middle of a critical operation and screw us over, which I'm sure you guys have seen tons of funny videos of people playing esports online and just getting punted right in the middle of a tournament. So Microsoft is making some changes. Microsoft is trying to do the right things in some areas, but don't let them pull the cape over your eyes. Microsoft is still critical about collecting your information, and they still need your information, because they've discovered that Google, Amazon, all these other companies that collect your information and sell your information and use your information to market to you, Microsoft's starting to learn that that is a very lucrative business. And Microsoft wants to bring that to the OS, because that's the one thing Google can't do and Amazon can't do. They're trying to get that information faster, sooner, and try to get that information that nobody else can, because they own the operating system that's on your computer, and it's our responsibility to stop them. Unless, of course, you really could care less and don't care what information Microsoft takes from your computer, in which case, I envy you. But unfortunately, I'm not one of those people. I do a lot of critical stuff. I do a lot of stuff that's under NDA. I contract with companies and do a lot of stuff that's hush-hush that I really don't want Microsoft uploading. All the names of the files I'm opening, metadata, and also when applications crash, I don't want Microsoft sending the dump file, which is the critical piece of information needed to debug or reverse engineer a piece of software, up to the Microsoft cloud. And I'm sure a lot of you guys don't want that to happen either. So please leave a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think about this video. I will make more of these videos in the future, because I am vigilant about keeping Microsoft in their place. My operating system on my desktop computer is my utopia. I don't care about my cell phone. I know everybody's stealing everything from cell phones. Google, Apple, everybody. They're not super trustworthy companies to begin with, but they're also straightforward with us in what they're collecting. What I do have a problem with is Microsoft collecting a lot of stuff behind the scenes in my house, which is my desktop computer. This is my home. This is my privacy. This is where I get to take off my underwear and strut around my house nude and not worry about the neighbors calling the cops because the blinds are closed. Well, Microsoft wants those blinds open, and they want my neighbors to see my wang, and they want your neighbors to see your wang. So I say we put up a little bit of a fight. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Until next time.